Life on Chemin des Dames was not all bad. They didn't have to sleep in muddy trenches because they had a comfortable, disused quarry near the village of Craonne.
We're at the famous quarry that you see in our movie. This is where Stubby, Conroy, the boys of the 102nd, this is where they lived. Now this quarry here originally had been in the hands of the Germans from 1914 to the end of 1917. When the boys arrived from the 102nd, they lived in the caves, Stubby lived in the caves with them, and now I'm going to show you something really cool.
Et voilà, here it is, your new home.
Sweet dreams.
Hi, I'm Richard. I'm the director of Sergeant Stubby, an American Hero. When we decided to make the movie, we really had to do a lot of research, which involved visiting locations in France and the US. I want to share this with you now as I take you on a journey following in Stubby's paw prints. This is the closest we can get to Stubby's paw prints with any certainty. Sure, we know they were in other cities and towns, but not precisely where. Towns change, ruins get rebuilt, forests regrow, and memories fade. We know he was in these caves. Letters, engravings and drawings from his fellow soldiers in the 102nd confirm it.
Great. Now they want us to live like cavemen.
It's not too bad. At least we have running water.
And lots of charming company.
This is incredible. I'm in the tunnels where Stubby and Conroy lived for 2 months. There are more than 15 miles of tunnels here with wonderful German engineering. They originally put toilets in here, they put electricity. Behind me is a shrine to Stubby with a plaque and his photographs there. He's a dog that's well known in this area.
50 feet below ground, we can see proof that the soldiers spent a good while down here. The intricate carvings and artwork would have taken a considerable amount of time and effort to do. I'm astonished by the level of detail. It makes me wonder, was it boredom or homesickness or the sense they were part of a world-changing event that needed to be recorded forever that inspired them to do it? Also, I'm fascinated that neither side defaced the other's artwork. We see German next to French, next to American carvings. It's like there was respect among these enemies, no matter how hard they fought one another above ground. The caves are incredible. I could spend a whole month down here just wandering around. They clearly provided a welcome refuge from the war raging above. And it looks very much like the American soldiers made them as homely as possible. They added their little touches even in this damp darkness. From poems to sweethearts, or insignia of their favorite baseball team, the cave art represents a small piece of America 3,000 miles from home.
Join the army, see the world.
Ugh, I need a wash.
It really wasn't so bad. There were one or two things, like further down we discovered some wire netting. Soldiers covered themselves with the wire netting when they slept so they wouldn't be attacked by the rats.
Well, Stubby, this is it. You better get some shut-eye.
But I'm sure when Stubby came, that was the end of the rats.
Evidently, Stubby wasted no time in making himself useful. He began by clearing the vermin from the trenches.
A soldier, Sergeant John Curtin, was asleep in these caves during a gas attack. But he was awakened by a frantic Stubby nudging his gas mask towards him. It saved his life. But after the war, Curtin wrote a poem to Stubby. Listen to me, and I will tell of a dog who went all through hell. With 102nd Infantry, USA, Stubby was with us night and day. He was smuggled across the sea and was certainly full of glee. When he landed at Saint-Nazaire, he and Bob were a happy pair. Near Neufchâteau, he stayed a while, and in hiking covered many a mile. Then in February, we left for the front, and Stubby was ready to do his stunt. A month and a half on Chemin-des-Dames, Stubby behaved just like a lamb. Then we went to Beaumont near Toul, and Stubby showed he was no fool. He always knew when to duck the shells and buried his nose at the first gas smells. But once, a shell fragment struck in his breast. Wounded in action, was Stubby blessed. He went all through Chateau Thierry Drive and came out of it very much alive. Then to Saint-Mihiel, Stubby came and helped chase the Germans from the plain. North of Verdun were our hardest battles, and many brave men gave their death rattles. But Stubby came through hell okay, and is ready to go back to the USA. He is a fighting bulldog of the old YD, and is the joy and pride of our company. When we take him back to the USA, Stubby will hold stage night and day. His owner Bob will take him home, and never more will Stubby roam. He'll enjoy a much-earned rest in the place we all love best. Life in the comparative safety of the caves at Craonne was not to last. In April of 1918, Stubby, Conroy and their buddies would leave the peaceful sector at Chemin-des-Dames.
You know, on a night like this, we can forget about the war.